Do you feel like you're trapped with the same old pencil-pushing, textbook-lugging, confined options when choosing which classes to sign up for next year? There might be an alternative that may suit you better than traditional classes. There is a course here at West Allis Central where you can experience learning in a hands-on, exciting, real-life way. Set yourself free and experience a class that will not only create knowledge, but adventures that you'll never forget. Are you ready for the journey? We call it environmental science.
Go ahead. That was good.
Hi there. I'm Mr. Gain, instructor for environmental science, an elective course offering here at West Allis Central. I've put together this brief video to give you an overview of this fantastic opportunity for you, the junior or senior to be here at Central. I hope that I can give you a general idea of what this course has to offer, along with some important advice about prerequisites, the subject areas covered by this course, and whether or not this is the best option for you in conjunction with your post-high school plans. The first thing that you should know is that there are actually two environmental science courses offered here at West Allis Central. One is 4210, which is the fall section, and the other is 4220, which is the spring section. Each section is a separate class which has its own unique curriculum. You may sign up for both fall and spring semester together in the same year, or you can sign up for one or the other. Oftentimes, sophomores who will be completing a chemistry class this year may opt to take one of the environmental science courses offered during their junior year and then take the other one that they didn't take during their senior year, and that's perfectly acceptable. This course is designed to increase students' awareness of environmental issues within the state of Wisconsin. Keeping local issues as the main focus of the course gives students the opportunity to understand what's happening around them on a daily basis. For first semester environmental science, we begin with a historical look at the environment, focusing on Native American Indians of Wisconsin and how they use the environment to survive. Next, we talk about settlement of Europeans here in the Wisconsin area and how some of those people, through their early conservation efforts, made a difference then and today. Wisconsin tree identification is also incorporated into this section of the course. Types of water, water properties, and water chemistry are covered as well, with environmental protection for nature and wildlife being the main focus. Common fish of Wisconsin are also incorporated in this section of the course. Air quality and pollution prevention is the next area covered, and then we move into wildlife management with a focus on the Wisconsin deer herd. The semester is completed with a focus on endangered, threatened, and protected species of Wisconsin and throughout the world. To begin semester two, we look at winter wildlife adaptations of animals here in Wisconsin, basically how they make it through the cold winters we have here. And then we go into animal tracking, an important wildlife management technique, as well as trapping to control populations, which transitions into mammals of Wisconsin specifically. Next, we cover winter survival strategies for humans, and then we move on to energy conservation and alternative energy sources. We see how the Earth's resources are quickly being used up with the growing global population. We also take a look at how we map the land that we have at our use, how we travel on the land that we have at our use, and how we eventually decide to use the land within the community setting, looking at West Allis specifically. Some land use practices that we will be covering in depth include waste management, agriculture, mining and other means of extracting raw materials from beneath the Earth's surface, and forestry. Next, we take a look at some of the more common birds found here in Wisconsin. This section of the course usually includes embryonic development and an egg hatching exercise. To finish up the school year, we take a look at what are known as exotic species, or species that were not native to Wisconsin but have invaded our area and have made a significant impact on the ecosystem here. One of the best ways for students to understand more about the environment is to give them hands-on opportunities for exploration, reinforcing what we learn in the classroom through field trip experiences. Many field trip opportunities exist for each semester, which correspond with the subject areas covered. A canoe trip is taken in the fall semester in October, and again in the second semester in May. These trips are a very important part of the course and are available to all students who choose to attend. Many additional experiences exist which you may have the chance to take part in. You can see some of the other field trip opportunities here. To satisfy the requirements for taking this course, you must first have completed any level of biology. Completion of any level of chemistry is also required for enrollment into this course. Priority for applicants for the course will be given to seniors, and grade point average will also play a factor in determining acceptance into the course. If you satisfy the prerequisites and you'd like to take the course, just enroll. Most students who sign up get a spot in the class as long as scheduling conflicts don't exist. Students need to understand before applying for this particular course that it is a science course at West Allis Central, but may not be counted as a core science course for some of the colleges that you may enroll at. Some colleges will take this class as a core science credit, and some will not. You must treat it as an elective class if you decide to sign up. I'd like to thank you for all your time and attention. If you have any questions, you can ask your instructor, or feel free to stop by room 223 and talk to me, Mr. Gain, directly. I hope to see many of you next year, ready to learn through activities, adventures, and fun. Environmental Science, where the outdoors is our classroom.